How are you feeling now?
Good. Fine. Back at work.
What line of work are you in?
Waste management consultant.
Yeah, they'll talk to you while you're in transit. And you'll visualize not taking any chances. But meet them halfway with love, peace, and persuasion. And expect them to rise for the occasion. And it gratifies when you see it materialize right in front of your eyes. By surprise. La 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 la. 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 Yeah, we'll send you glad tidings from New York. Open up your eyes so you may see. Ask you not to read between the lines. Hope that you will come right in on time. Oh, oh, oh. And they'll lay you down low in the easy.
You know, Quasimodo predicted all this.
Who did what?
All these problems, the Middle East, the end of the world.
Nostradamus. Quasimodo's the Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Hey!
don't know, it was just a trip having those wild creatures come into my pool and have their little babies.
All the stories have been told of kings in days of old, but there's no England now. All the wars that were won or lost somehow don't seem to matter very much anymore. All the lies we were told, all the lives of the people running round, their castles are burned. Oh, I see change, but inside we're the same as we ever were. Living on a thin line, ooh, tell me now, what are we supposed to do? Living on a thin line, ooh, tell me now.
Let me tell you something. Nowadays, everybody's got to go to shrinks and counselors and go on Sally, Jesse, Raphael and talk about their problems. Whatever happened to Gary Cooper? The strong, silent type. He wasn't in touch with his feelings. He just did what he had to do. I had a semester and a half of college, so I understand Freud. I understand therapy as a concept. But in my world, it does not go down.
asked me why, I just went on and told her. She asked me why, I just went on and told her. She asked me why, I just went on and told her. She asked me why, I just went on and told her.
That in the air blow the whistle on the fireman, he rang the bell. That in the air blow the whistle on the fireman, he rang the bell. That in the air blow the whistle on the fireman, he rang the bell. That in the air blow the whistle on the fireman, he rang the bell.
Fucking King Midas in reverse here. Everything I touch turns to shit. You got any idea what my life would be worth if certain people found out I checked into a laughing academy?
She asked me why, I just went on and told her. She asked me why, I just went on and told her.
The morning of the day I got sick, I've been thinking. It's good to be in something from the ground floor. I came too late for that, I know. But lately I'm getting the feeling that I came in at the end. The best is over.
What about you?
What? Hell? You been listening to me? No. For the same reasons. We're soldiers. No. Soldiers don't go to hell. It's war. Soldiers, they kill other soldiers. We're in a situation where
Everybody involved knows the stakes. And if you're going to accept those stakes, you got to do certain things.
We'll be right back. adventures. This is a hawk's body with your face on it, shrunk down to the size of a fist. Many a hero has been brought down like Samson by a perfidious bar.
Wow.
So does that justify everything that you do?
Excuse me, let me tell you something. When America opened the floodgates and let all us Italians in, what do you think they were doing it for? Because they were trying to save us from poverty? No, they did it because they needed us. They needed us to build their cities and dig their subways and to make them richer. The Carnegies and the Rockefellers, they needed worker bees, and there we were. But some of us didn't want to swarm around their hive and lose who we were. We wanted to stay Italian and preserve the things that meant something to us. Honor and family and loyalty. And some of us wanted a piece of the action. Now, we weren't educated like the Americans, but we had the balls to take what we wanted.
Thank you. don't stop the motion. If you get the notion, you can't stop the groove, cause you just won't move. Got my sunroof down, got my diamond in the back. Put on your second ring, woman, if you thought I. If you get the notion, you can't stop the groove, cause you just won't move. Got my sunroof down, got my diamond in the back. Put on your shaggy wiggle, woman, if you know what I ain't gonna play. Shame, 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 shame on you, if you can't dance too. Shame, 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 shame. We'll be right back.
wanna be Americano, Americano, Americano. Gotta buy a diamond ring, cause that's his baby's favorite thing. Okay, alright, yeah, man, wanna be American, wanna be American. For the stars, grab that golden ring. Just remember, he's Americano. Well, watch it, pal, cause he'll take everything. He wanna be Americano, Americano, Americano. He wants to drive a Cadillac. Ooh, now he's chasing showgirls, smoking camels, whiskey and soda. He likes that rock and roll. He's playing baseball. Loves Marilyn Monroe. A Coca-Cola Joe.
Don't get a man up there. Hey, Tom. How's it going?
You didn't get sick?
Nah.
How much you weigh?
8 pounds.
Lost a lot of weight.
Swimming. The best exercise. Works every muscle group.
Get the fuck out of here. You never exercised once in your life.
Anyway, $4 a pound. You know I've been working with the government, right, Tom?
Don't say it.
Come on, Tom. Sooner or later, you gotta face facts.
I don't wanna hear it.
Well, you're gonna hear it.
Still love me, answer me, baby, yes I would. I'll put you above me. If I were a miller at a mill wheel grinding, would you miss your color box, your soft shoes shining? If I were a carpenter and you were a lady, would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby? Would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby?
Thank you.
You've been a solid performer for some time now. Plus, you're my brother-in-law. You get older, you think about things.
You're a young man. We both are. World's still in front of us.
Boss. My estimate historically, 80% of the time it ends up in the can, like Johnny Sack. Or on the embalming table at Cozzarelli's.
Don't even say that.
No risk, no reward.
I mean, yeah, our line of work, it's always out there. You probably don't even hear it when it happens, right?
Why don't you get the fuck out of here before I shove your quotations book up your fat fucking ass?